Good morning, student. This is Miss Teena, PGT Biology, Kendriya Vidyalaya, Tinsukia. Today we are going to start with chapter number 1 of Biology textbook class 12. The name of the chapter is Reproduction in Organism. As you can infer out from the name itself that this chapter is all about reproduction. So here we are going to study the three topics, that is the lifespan, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. So let's start with our first topic, that is the lifespan. As we all know that each and every organism can live only for a certain period of time. So this period of time from their birth to their natural death is known as their lifespan. The lifespan of an organism may be of few minutes or of several thousand years. So different organisms have the different lifespan. You can get this thing in a better way after observing this slide. Here in this slide you can see the lifespan of some organisms are given. As you can see, in case of fruit fly the lifespan is 1 day. In case of butterfly it is 1 to 2 weeks, wheat plant 6 months. Then last examples, banyan tree has lifespan of 200 years. So lifespan is different of different organisms. Then in third point, lifespan of organisms are not necessarily correlated with their sizes. Means it is not necessary that the two organisms which is like having the same size, they are not going to have the same lifespan. In case of crow and parrot, here you can see that the lifespan of crow is 15 years and of parrot is 140 years. They are almost of the same size, but their lifespan is different. Now we are going to start with our next topics. So have you ever wondered how vast number of plant of animal species have existed on earth for several thousand of years? So there must be a process, or there must be some process in living organism that ensure this continuity of species generation after generation. Right, we are talking about reproduction. So what is reproduction? Reproduction is a biological process in which an organism gives rise to young ones. See, it is a biological process in which an organism is giving rise to the young ones, or also known as the offspring. But what kind of offspring they are giving rise to? The offspring which are similar to itself. Means an elephant cannot give the offspring of the dog. An elephant can give rise to the offspring of elephant only. So why this process, this reproduction is required? Basically, what is the necessity of reproduction? Well, reproduction ensures the continuity of species generation after the generation. Well, there is a large diversity in the biological world, and each and every organism has evolved its own mechanism to multiply and produce the offspring. And on the basis of whether the two parents are involved in producing the offspring, or the only one or a single parents are involved in producing offspring, there are two types of reproduction, that is asexual reproduction and the sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, only one single parent is involved and there is no formation or fusion of the gamete. In sexual reproduction, there is involvement or participation of two parents, and there is a fusion of male and female gametes occur. So in this part we are going to study in detail specifically about the asexual reproduction. So what is asexual reproduction? We have already talked about it. So asexual reproduction, in this type of reproduction, the offsprings are produced by the single parent and there is no formation or fusion of gamete. As you can see that only single parent is involved, so there is not even requirement of formation or fusion of gamete. So offspring are genetically identical to their parents. The offspring which are produced in during this mode of reproduction, they are genetically identical to their parents. Not only genetically, they are even morphologically identical to their parents. Morphologically identical means they are similar in appearance. So These kind of offsprings, which are morphologically and genetically similar to their parents, are known as the clones. So the offspring produced by the asexual reproduction, they can also be called as or termed as the clones. Asexual reproduction is generally shown in the organisms which are unicellular, or the plants or animals which is having the simple organization. The animals or the plant which are having the complex organization, they do not generally show the asexual reproduction, but the plants and animals which is having the simple organization are involved in the asexual mode of reproduction. So there are various methods by which the different organism produced asexually. So here in this slide, I am going to show the one method by which organism multiply asexually. So the single cell organism of kingdom Monera and Protista reproduce by simple cell division called the binary fission. What happens in binary fission? You can see bi means two and fission means split. So here the organisms split into the two organisms. Here you can see in this diagram that apparent amoeba is breaking into the two daughter amoeba, or splitting into the two daughter amoeba. In this process, first it is the nucleus which divides into two, later on the cytoplasm divide into two and forms the two daughter amoeba. So this binary fission is generally occur in case of amoeba or in paramecium. Then the next second or the next type of asexual reproduction is multiple fission. In this type, as you can infer out from the name itself, multiple means there are many kind of organism are going to produced by the fission process. Fission means splitting. So in this, parent cell divides into or split into many individuals. So this is generally is seen in the case of plasmodium and entamoeba. Then the next type of asexual reproduction is the budding. This budding is generally seen in the case of yeast or in the case of hydra. So in this process, what happens is a small buds are produced on the parent organisms, and then this bud initially it remains attached to the parents. Okay, and later on it gets separated and forms a separated individual. Then the next type of, in most of the fungi, not most, in some fungi and simple plants like algae, they reproduce through spatial reproductive structures. So there are various kind of reproductive structure which help in the reproduction of these fungi and simple plants. So the first reproductive structure is the zoospores. Zoospores are, these are the motile spores. Here you can see in this figure, these are the zoospores. These are the motile asexual spores, okay, which helps in the reproduction. So these are generally seen in the case of algae and fungi. And the example of the algae which is generally reproduced by the zoospore is the Chlamydomonas. These zoospores, they use flagellum for their locomotion. The next type of reproductive structure is conidia. These are the asexual spores of the fungus generated by the mitosis. This is conidia is generally used as a reproductive structure in the penicillium. So penicillium is reproduced by with the help of these reproductive structures known as conidia. Then the buds are also a reproductive structure. A bud basically develops as an outgrowth in the hydra. These buds develop into the tiny individual. Then when these buds, they become fully mature, they detaches itself and they become a new independent individual. And in case of sponges, the reproductive structure which help in the reproduction of sponges is the gemmules. Gemmules are what? These are basically the internal buds of the sponges. Then in case of plants, in case of plant, asexual reproduction is termed as the vegetative propagation. What is vegetative propagation? Vegetative propagation, it is the production of offspring from the vegetative propagules of plant. Now, what is vegetative propagules? So, vegetative propagules are basically the units of vegetative propagation, means these are the structures or these are the thing which is involved in the reproduction of these particular plant. So, why this is known as vegetative? Well, vegetative means the parts which are other than the reproductive parts of the plant are known as vegetative parts. So, the parts which is involved in the, so vegetative propagules are basically the parts which are involved in the vegetative propagation of the plant. So, example of vegetative propagules are given below of some plants. As in case of potato tuber, you can see in potatoes there are buds, and these buds are also known as eyes. So, here in the potato tuber, it is the buds which are involved in the reproduction of this or propagation of this particular plant. In case of ginger and in case of banana also, these rhizomes are involved in the propagation of these particular plants. So, what are basically rhizomes? Rhizomes, these rhizomes have nodes. These are basically the modified stems and they have nodes. And when these nodes come in contact with the damp soil and water, they produce roots and the new plants. Then another example of vegetative propagation is given here, that is the buds of the bryophyllum. I hope you all have observed this leaf of bryophyllum plant. In this leaf you can see in the margins of the leaves of this plant, you can see the in the notches of the margins of this plant, there are some buds arises. So, these buds are generally known as adventitious buds. So, these buds, they develop into a new plant. They help in the propagation of the bryophyllum plant. Then the next type which is involved in the vegetative propagation of a plant is the bulb. So, what is bulb? Is basically a modified stem, and it has fleshy leaves, and it is generally seen in case of onion and garlic. So, this also helps in the propagation of these particular plants. So, in case if you will just sow this bulb, it will give rise to a new plant. Then there is also another example, bulbil. Bulbil is basically, these are the tiny bulb-like structure which are formed in the angle between a leaf and a stem or in a place of flowers on certain plants. So, when they are full size, when these bulbils are full sized, they fall off and they are removed and they are planted to produce the new plants. So, the plants like agave and onion are generally being produced like these. Then there are runners. Runners, they are also the unit of reproduction or vegetative propagation. The runners plants are generally the plants which grow horizontally along the ground. So, here I have not written the example, but it is the strawberry which is actually produced with the help of these runner. Then the sucker is there. In case of cherry, sucker is basically, this is generally seen in the case of cherry. Sucker, it is basically a basal shoot which grows from the root or base of the stem. Here you can see in this diagram that a shoot or a stem is growing from the root or a base of the stem of the parent plant. Then the next is the offset. Offset is also a vegetative propagule. It is a small complete daughter plant that asexually produced on the mother plant. And it is generally, actually the water hyacinth is the example of this offset which is produced with the help of the offspring. So here we are going to discuss about this particular example, water hyacinth. As one question is generally asked from this particular topic in your CBSC exam, that water hyacinth is known as the terror of Bengal. So why this water hyacinth is known as terror of Bengal? Well, this water hyacinth is an invasive breed. It was first introduced in India because of its pretty flowers and the shape of the leaf. But now it is considered as terror of Bengal because it is repeatedly produced by the vegetative method offset in the short period. So in a very short span of time, it covers around the entire water body. And when it covers entire water body, so it will require the oxygen also for this vegetative propagation. So it drains off the oxygen from the water where it is growing, and it leads to the death of the fishes living in that water body. So hence it is considered as a water weed. Water hyacinth scientifically also known as Eucornea. So here I have written only Eucornea, but it is also known as Eucornea crassipes. The complete name of the water, scientific name of the water hyacinth is the Eucornea crassipes. Okay, so I'm going to stop this video here only. In the next part of the video, I'm going to deal with the next topic, that is the sexual reproduction. Thank you.